today. I will be showing you update on my garden and what it looks like. So here we go. These are my greens I planted. I had to separate them. And this is what it looks like. Trying to get a nicer picture here. Let's get it. Yeah. These are my greens. Down there on that corner down there is my okra. Looking very healthy. I don't know what happened in this spot here, but looks like nothing wants to grow there. Even going on back there, I have okra and I have elephant ear planted in. Well, there was a big elephant ear in there, and I took it up, and a bunch of little pups is coming up. Right there, it's about 10 of them, 10 or 15 pups in here. That's not what I wanted, but if anyone would like for me to ship them one, give me a holler and I would gladly do that. You just have to pay for shipping. But I would send it to you. Even have one growing in that thing right there. It wasn't something I was trying to do. I was trying to grow a zucchini, green zucchini in there, but it didn't come up. But check this out. This is something I want to show you here. It is amazing. Right here. I plant this zucchini in the inside of this. I cut the bottom out of the container, and it started growing in there. And I just left it in there out of curiosity. I said, I'm gonna see if it's gonna find its way out of that small hole in that. That's a 2-liter water bottle. You know, the real big one. And it came up out of there by itself. No help. It just found its way up out of there. So this is where we at. Things going good. I'm going to take you guys to my table. Oh, and there are, right there, a tomato bush coming up in here. The one there. I didn't plant these. It just came up. There's one over there. And I didn't show you the one over here. Oh, and there's one right there. They just coming up everywhere. And right here is my table to start my seedlings, but nothing grew in these cups because there's like big pieces of wood chips in there, and the seeds can't find their way around those so they end up, they just died. I had a couple of seeds that come up fine. These here are supposed to be pole beans, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted beans that I could snap and eat them that way instead of shelling them, because I have such a small area to grow things in. I wanted to be able to grow plenty and, you know, still get enough. Like these are sugar snap, sugar, there's some type of sugar bean, I forgot the name of them, but they coming up pretty well. I'm happy with that. You know, you can use these in stir fry. A few carrots in there. They're doing well. These are eggplant. I love eggplants. They're doing well. I got one cabbage come up in this container when I first planted it, and these are the second go round. I put these in there the second time to make sure I get a nice harvest out of here. So I got those started. These are the green cabbage, and I got 2-3 sides. So all of these is my green cabbages, and these are the leftover greens. These are the greens that I had left over when I pulled everything up. And you can see the greens are a nice size, but I'm trying to find somewhere to put these greens, because I'm still cleaning up back here in this area. I'm still trying to move stuff. So let me take you over here. This is another box I built. That tomato plant come up by itself. I didn't plant that. I don't know what's up with that, but it's come up by itself. But I'm saving this area for something else. And I'm using this as a little composting bin. So there's a lot of vegetables down there up under that soil. It's like wood chips down in there. I think it was topsoil. Yeah, I just pulled topsoil in there. And here is my cucumbers. I think they need to be dusted. Yeah, they do. They need to be dusted. I see something trying to eat them. And I know they planted too close together, but it's the only place I had to put them. So I'm going to cut one of these loose, because in every little cubicle, I put two plants, seeds. And all of them came up, but I gotta cut at least one of them. So instead of six, wait a minute, how many is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, instead of 12, I have six. So I gotta cut one away from every cubicle that I put in the ground. Because it was two to every cubicle. Now I know my tomato bushes is too close together, but I didn't have anywhere to put them, and I didn't want to just throw my seeds away. See, they go all the way down there. I mean, my plants, they go all the way down there, and I didn't want to just throw them away. But I know in reality I might have to remove them. And remember when I told you I didn't have a place to put the greens? I put the greens here in front. So I'm gonna have to make sure the tomatoes stay off of the greens. Yeah, I'm gonna make sure the tomatoes stay off the greens. And right here, I forgot. I keep forgetting the name of this here. I come back to that. But this is broccoli. This is my broccoli. It's doing well. It just needs to be pulled up and replanted. See, they all crowded in there. But I'm gonna have them going all the way back there. That's where they're gonna be found. So there's enough room for those. I love broccoli, and that's what I'm gonna do. I keep trying to think of the name of that right there. It should have been harvest, but I haven't done it. I can't think. Anybody know the name of that? Put it in the comment section. I can't remember what it was. And these are my they look like they dying, because I pulled them up to make room for my kale. These are mustards. This is the only place I had to put them, so I put them outside the fence. If they don't grow, you know, they don't recover, no biggie. I found something else to put there. And I did put some soil with I dug the trench. I put some soil in there with fertilizer. And that's, I don't know. We'll see how that work out. Everything is experiment around here. And I got grass growing. I'm not growing the grass. It's just growing. But here's my onions. I love onions. So I had to move them. It's raining so much here. You know, and I didn't want them to get too much water and die on me. So I put them up under here. Check this out, you guys. This is my, what you call it? The, I can't think of my peppers. And I know the name of the peppers. Darn, I need to have a little paper list. Because I can't think of the name. But a lot of you guys know what these is. If you're a gardener, you know what these are. They grow a lot of small peppers on them. And I got that from one bush. I think I bought it from the store. I think I bought that bush from the store, and I have one. And this is what I got from it. I think this ants, I'm about to hit something, do something about these ants, because they can cause problems. Be a little dirt up around the bottom. Yeah, they will be dying. And this is more mustards. I don't even like mustards that much. And I planted these, some more type of peppers, and I planted the whole bag, and this is the only one that came up. I think that's the one that people cook in their food. They put the whole pepper in there and just let it cook. And these are tomatoes that I had left, and I didn't have nowhere to put them, so I left them there. This is ginger. I am tempting to plant. I soaked it in water, but I gotta find a place for it and put a little dirt on over it so it'll come up. I had ginger before. It didn't do so well, but I wanna try it again. And right here, this tomato bush here, it grows, I mean, it is the best tomato bush that you can grow. It's those Roman tomatoes, those little long tomatoes, and it has like 5 tomatoes on there that I can see. And I don't know if you guys can see it right there. Let me see if I can focus it in. Let me see if I can focus this in. But it's right there. All the wire might be in the way. Let me see if I can focus this. Hold on, you guys. I'm not a camera pro, but I'm trying to zoom in on these tomatoes. They're in there. I don't know if you can see them or not, but they're in there. And there is 2 nice size ones right there. There's 2 nice size ones. They're green, blending in with the foliage, but right there. A bunch of them right there. Okay, I'm gonna take you guys in and show you the inside of this garden. I know we fuzzy. Give me a minute. Let me straighten this out. Give me a minute. Let me straighten it out. This isn't. These are another type of kale. Yeah. These are another type of kale. A lot of them died. A lot of them still, you know, live. That was in the area, you know, where it wasn't too many kale pieces, you know, plants around it, so it was able to thrive because it had its own place. So right here, I replanted some here in the front. It might be too many once it starts growing, But I was going to crop them the other day, and I said I was going to wait. It been raining here like crazy. And this is the sugar apple plant. This is a sugar apple, and it's blooming. See the blooms here? So we will have some sugar apples soon. Yeah, we will have sugar apples soon. It's blooming everywhere. Okay, and right here, this is another pool. Another pool I have. But I decided to put more of those kale in here, try to grow them there. And that the onions there have been there for so long. They've been there for so long. So if you buy onions out of the store, put them in the ground and plant them. At the tops, put them in the ground and plant them, and you'll always have them. You know, they're not easy. They're not hard to take care of. Yeah, Tabasco. Oh, I got the name now. This is a Tabasco plant. This is, see all of the little peppers on it? And that's the way it grows. It grows so many peppers on it. You trim it down in the wintertime when it finna get cold. And when it comes back full. I've been had this plant for over 3 years now. And I'm very proud of this plant. And right here is another, this bed that I cleaned out where I had the mustard greens in. I cleaned it out and I put, and this is kale. All this is kale. I love kale, so I can't wait for that to get big and looking all pretty. I'm gonna show you guys that and check my greens out. Check this out. Yeah, they gotta be cropped, but I didn't want to crop them until I show you guys my greens. I had to show you guys my greens before I crop them. Look at that. Yeah, I had to show you guys first. I want you to see my greens before I crop them. I'm trying to get a big, good view. And on this side over here, these are my greens also. Look. I got greens all back there. They are smaller ones, but they are coming up. And they're coming up nice. Look at those big, beautiful leaves. Look at those leaves. Look at that. Look at that. I will be cropping these today. We will be eating these this afternoon or tonight. Let me see. I can get a better picture for you guys. Yeah, those are all my greens. I will be cropping them tonight. And I have dinosaur kale. I have about 4 in there. I gotta remove them because, as you guys know, plants don't do well when they're covered by other plants and they can't get the sun. It will stun their growth. Yeah, it will stun their growth. And in that thing there, I have turmeric. It dies down in the wintertime and it comes back in the summer. And I'll show you guys that when it comes back. Check this out though. I had supposed to be some type of calaloo here in this area. I pulled all of those up, but my daughter told me they're perennials. They would drop and keep coming back, and I didn't want that. So I planted more turnips. Look at all those turnips. They got to be separated and replanted so they don't kill each other out. But I know I'm going to have some left over, because I know there's just no way all of those is gonna fit in the little area. I wish I had land. If I had land, I'd be growing plenty, my son told me. And this tomato bush, it grew over this way. Oh, I see more tomatoes growing. Oh my God. I think this is the tomato vine, These are the tomatoes I will be growing. Right here, I will be growing these because these have a high harvest rate. I'm trying to focus in, but these have a high harvest rate, and I think these are the ones I will be growing. I didn't prune anything. I didn't take off any succulents. It's just growing. And it's so many growing on it. I see some growing out here. I see some growing on this thing here. So if I can get a lot by not pruning them, and they still grow, you know, get to be a nice size, I'm just gonna grow those right there. I like them. And I had to move one turnip from right there because it was so many branches coming out over the turnip, and it was raining so much in the ground, I guess it stayed too wet, and the turnip couldn't get the air and the sun it needed to balance all that water from it raining, and it rotted. So I'm gonna crop these here. These are gonna be cropped today. These are my bigger ones, and they are going to be cropped. I love turnips. I already got my smoke wings ready. I got my smoke turkey wings ready to go in the pot. Yes, I got it ready. And we will be eating some of these bad boys right here today. And I mean, the root was so huge. The root was huge. I wish I could show you another root. See this root right here? It was way huger. I don't know why. It was huger than that root there. Now that's a huge root. It was huger than that. Let me show you. Here's another one. See, that's a huge root also, but I don't want it to go bad. I'm hoping it don't. But this is what I'm gonna be doing today. I will be out here separating these and spreading these out in the garden so we can have more turnips, and I think we'll have more greens then we probably can handle. So I'll probably be blanching and putting them in the refrigerator, freezing them, so we will have them. Yep, so we'll have them. So I'm getting myself ready in case anything go down. I'll already have my food ready to go and back here. I'm just trying to get a start on. I remember when I first got started. Well, that we'll talk about that another day. But yeah, things looking really, really good. I just got to finish cleaning up back here. I got my, well, I'll talk about that too later on. But I got plenty of seeds. God, I know the name of that right there. Following Yahshua and Miss T, Sister T. It's not a name now, but I remember he was saying something about that plant, and I went and got that plant, those seeds, and I planted some. And someone say that those are like a type of spinach. Yeah, a type of spinach. So darn, I can't think of what it is. I'll think about it later. But anyway, turn the camera around. I will be saying bye to you guys. See you later. I love you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and leave a thumbs up. See you guys. Bye. Love you. Bye-bye.